What's going on, everybody? This is Nick from House of Paint 203. We are going to be tackling the giant ape over the next few episodes. Giant ape, one of the larger releases in the Wave 12 launch from Nolzer's Marvelous Miniatures and WizKids Games. My personal favorite beast to polymorph into. Currently, I'm playing a sorcerer in a campaign that's been going on for over a year. And whenever my sorcerer uses polymorph, he polymorphs into a giant ape. Because look at this thing. He's an absolute beast, an absolute tank. Let's take him out of the pack. All right, so there he is, the giant ape, out of his blister pack. And just for some scale, now the giant ape is categorized as a huge beast. And here's my player character. This is Hal. Hal would be classified as a medium humanoid. So you can definitely see the discrepancy. A giant ape packs a mean punch, and it's definitely one of the most formidable options for a player to polymorph into using the spell, the fourth level spell polymorph. Once you get up to true polymorph, then you could polymorph into pretty much anything, I believe, that you want. But polymorph restricts you only to the list of beasts that are in the monster manual or anything that is categorized as a beast. The giant ape you'll find in the appendices in the monster manual in the section labeled miscellaneous creatures, and that's where you'll find stats on this bad boy. But we're not worried about his stats today. We're worried about his aesthetics. Let's paint him. Dominic Maria, owner and founder of Credit UK, all the way across the pond in the UK. Dominic is a crafter of dice, dice boxes, dice vaults, dice towers, you name it. Dominic has tons of amazing accessories for you to bring to your gaming table immediately. Check his stuff out. Once again, that is Credit UK, and information on how to follow Dominic will immediately be following the video. Also, while you're here, be sure to smite like and slam subscribe so that I can continue bringing you these painting tutorials that I hope are at least somewhat helpful to you. All right, so we are going to get moving here with the giant ape. Obviously, a very, very large miniature, certainly the largest miniature that I've done on this show, and the second Wave 12 miniature that I'm tackling. Recently we did the Gorgon, and there he is in all his beauty. And now we're jumping in with the giant ape. So very excited for the base coat, his fur. I'm going to be using Abyssal Black from the Army Painter. For his flesh areas, his chest, his knuckles, his face, I'm going to be using Shadowed Stone from Master Series Paint. And for inside his mouth, I'm going to be base coating that with a heavy brown, and this is from Vallejo Game Color. There you go, heavy brown. And the reason I'm doing that is because I'm actually going to go in there with my purple ink afterwards and bring out some cool effects for inside his mouth. Some cool effects. Not going to spend a whole time on that, obviously, because that's not the focal point of the model. But pretty much going to be an all-over base coat of Abyssal Black. So, just shake it on up. My handy-dandy water cup. All right, and we are ready to go. Giant ape. All right, so I did was block out the areas that I want to have black with a large brush, because this is a large miniature. If I tried to Basecoat, this guy with my number two, I would be here all day. And since majority of his body is, of his fur is going to be that black, I just went ahead and blocked out the areas that I know I want to have black. Now I'm gonna go back in here with my number two and just kind of clear up some spots. Specifically around his feet and his hands. I'm not worried about having, you know, gone over in certain places because I'll be able to go over that with that gray. Just a little on the inside of his arm. Always revisit the black a little bit. I want to start applying that that gray. Should probably wait for that black to dry. So I actually am gonna wait for that black to dry. All right, so the black is officially dry, and we're gonna go in here with shadowed stone, and we're gonna pick out these gray areas on his body, specifically his flesh, the chest, the upper abdomen, and the face, and his hands and feet. Thin that out a little bit, as always. Let's get in here. I'm gonna just kind of guesstimate. Right now I'm just kind of blocking it out. This is like really watery. Like super diluted, oh well. I'm trying to pick off of it and I have to go back in with a second coat. To do a second coat. Yeah. This paint is very, very diluted. You can like hear it in the bottle. Like flipping, flopping around. I might call an audible. I might try lich skin. No, it's a little too light, but let me see what happens if I mix it with the shadowed stone. Actually, this might be a good highlight for him. Actually, it might be a really good highlight for him. All right, plan failed. But that's what these tests are for. Let's go. We'll power through. I'd rather have it be too thin than too thick, you know? Willing to bet that's not what she said. Trying to avoid it pooling. I'm trying to like treat it as a wash right now because this is like drunk. This paint is drunk. And I don't want it to go where I don't want it. What a mess. Sometimes these things happen, man. Right, I'm gonna see what I can get out of this. I'm gonna go into Dungeon Stone. Yeah, Dungeon Stone might have been the way to go from the beginning. Check out his foot. Thank you. glad I kind of sorted the gray situation out before I got to his face. His face is, you know, that's the money maker right there. I don't want to mess with the face. The other foot is going to go over this. The benefit of having that original shadowed stone be so thin. It's almost like you got 1.5 coats on here now instead of a full 2. So we're still in the driver's seat. And go into his mouth with the heavy brown. Here with a little bit more heavy brown. And it looks like the chest is done, and that's important for me because now I want to go in here and really establish the muscular frame of, it looks like I still have a wet glob here. I just want to go in here and establish the curvature of his pectorals, and I'm gonna actually put a shadow under his pecs to try and emphasize that. I'm being very, very gentle, very, very careful. And what I'm hoping for this to achieve is just some added definition. And it looks pretty pronounced right now, but my hope is that once I get the wash in here and start applying some highlights, that this will kind of fade into the realm of looking organic and normal. I'm gonna have to touch that up with a little gray and just kind of dull that down a little bit. Yeah, I think that'll look good once the washes and stuff are on. So I think we're good with part one of the giant ape. Really the base coating, but I mean, as you can see, the base coating was a project in itself. I mean, this guy is huge. Once again, bringing in my player character for scale, I mean, this is a medium humanoid. So this is, you know, your average player character right here. Average size adventurer compared to this monstrosity behind him. This is as big as you can get in the miscellaneous creatures appendices of the monster manual. So he is actually giant sized. He is, I don't know if you could see in the background, but I have some giants in the background. He's about the size of my fire giant. And I think the fire giant is 16 feet tall. I don't have the book open right now, but I think the fire giant's about 16 feet tall, or between 14 and 16 feet tall. So this guy's a force to be reckoned with, certainly a tank. And he's looking pretty good right now. All of his bases are applied where I want them, and in the next phase, we're going to be focusing in on those fleshy areas where we have the dungeon stone gray, and we're actually going to, I think what I'll do is probably do his mouth with violet ink, also because I'm going to be using that as a wash, and maybe hit his teeth, and then in the final phase, obviously, we'll put the highlights and dry brushing effects as well as hit this ground that he's standing on. As always, thank you for joining me. I could not wait to bust this out for personal reasons, but also because, I mean, this is just such a crazy sculpt. Information on how to follow me on all my social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, my website, immediately following the video and the post credits, as is information on how to follow Dominic Marriott, owner and founder of Credit UK. I will see you for part two.